AX-based communication with an ASP.NET Core application. In the first tutorial, in this tutorial we have explained a bare minimum code for posting a form. We have also discussed how the form data that is posted from the client side, that form data is collected at the server end. This is we have done already, and this has been done for the case of a post request. Today we shall learn how to send a GET request to a server, and also how to send parameters with it to the server, and how to obtain a string response back from the server after these parameters are processed at the server end. So this is what our plan is. As always, we shall keep the things as simple as we can. So we have just one text box and a send button. When this send is clicked, a please wait message will appear here briefly. That please wait message will appear, and the input string that is typed here, it will be sent to the server through an AJAX GET request. The server will then read that request and maybe do some processing with the string, and will send the string as response back to the client. The received string will then be displayed back on the same page so that we can verify that our request reached the server and then it came back also. So start by creating a new ASP.NET Core project by using an empty template so that we have an easy to understand project structure. So an empty template is the best way to start learning a new technology, and we have used an empty template. To your project, add a folder called Pages. This Pages, the spellings of this folder are important because the ASP.NET Core engine will look for our razor pages in this particular folder. If you change the names, then your project will not work. So the name of the folder must be Pages exactly as shown. After that, right click the Pages folder to add a new razor page called Index. The process we have already explained in a number of tutorials in the past. So you can add a page called Index. You will get two files as shown here. One file will be index.cshtml, the razor page, the file that will contain the razor syntax. And then the second file is of the same name, index.cshtml.cs. This will contain the backing class. So first of all, let us open the index.cshtml file to complete the razor markup, because this file will contain the razor markup, the input elements that we will be showing to the client side. This is the file that opens, and I have already completed this file. Now I will explain the various parts of this file. There are three directives: add page, add model, add tag helper. These are the basic plumbing that you must be familiar by now. Add page, it just the starting point of a razor page, so this must be present. Add model, it connects the backing class to this page. The backing class will be in the .cs file. Then add tag helper. This is used for the proper functioning of form elements on this page. After that, you see a span. This span will be used to show the please wait message. The color is red, and we have given an ID so that we can handle this span in our JavaScript code. And then we have a table. In this table, we have an input text. This text will be the text box, and then there is a send button. This button will be that send button which will be clicked. We have given ID to the input and given ID to the send button so that we can access them in the JavaScript, and then we can manipulate them and we can send our request to the client through these buttons. And after this, you see at the end of this page, we have written a script. This is JavaScript. So let us study the various parts of this script. First of all, button send dot add event listener. We are adding a click event to the send button. This is a function that is going to execute. And when this function executes, when the user has clicked this send button, in that case, the inner HTML of the please wait will change to please wait so that the user can understand that something is happening. Then after that, we are creating a URL to which our GET request will go. This slash means that it will basically be going to the home page, because index is only what we have added. But the important thing is that after that we have a query string like parameters handler. Handler is equal to makeUpper. MakeUpper will be the name of the function on the server side. We will be coming to that in a moment. So handler must be written like this. This is a fixed word. This is a fixed parameter. It must be spelled as handler exactly as I have done. Then the second parameter, this is the actual parameter. We have given it the name param. This will be the typed string in the text box. This will be sent as the param. I have written it simply like this, but you can use encoding and all that. I've just skipped that to keep the thing simple. This will be the name of the parameter. If the parameter had been named id, then I would have written and id is equal to. I can send as many parameters as I like, and it is better I encode them so that for security purposes this data goes in the correct way. But in this case I have not done to keep the things simple. So this is the way. This will be the name of the function and this will be the actual parameter. And after that, this is the fetch JavaScript function. This will cause an asynchronous AJAX request to this URL that we have constructed just now. The method will be specified as get. There is a comma and then there is this format, the JSON format, in which we specify the method as get. Then dot catch, this will log any network exceptions. In case there are some network problems, then we will get a log of them. So this is just the catch part. Then after that, there is a chain of dot then also. The dot then the response, this will be the response stream. This will also be obtained asynchronously. And inside this response, the function will be response.json. This will be asynchronous reading of that JSON. When the JSON is read, the server will be sending us JSON. So when that JSON is read, the JSON string will arrive in the parameter called, let us say, data. Then that data we will be using to set as the inner HTML of the same please wait, so that this signals us that the data has actually been received from the client, from the server side. So this is the decoded JSON, and the JSON will be a string, and therefore we have used it as the same string. Had the JSON been a complex object with properties, then we might have used some dot, etc. to access those properties. We'll take them in later lectures as we go, but right now it is a string, so we have done it like this. So you can have a look at the code. This is how it is. After this, next let us come to the Solution Explorer to complete the backing class in the index.cshtml.cs file. This will be the file that will contain our backing class, and there will be that function, the function that is going to process the request that is being sent by JavaScript. So this is the file that opens. These are the using directives. You can always refer to them in case you get some compilation errors. Then after that, public class index model is the name of the backing class. It comes from the page model class. This is the important part. Inside this, we have written a method called onGetMakeUpper. This is the method that is going to process the request that is coming from the client side. The return type of this method must be JSON result. This is very important. If you do not write JSON result or write something else, write IAction result, then in that case, this method will not receive the request. Then there is a parameter string param, the same parameter that we are sending from the client side. So you can see this is the URL we constructed on the client side. The URL we wrote as handler is equal to makeUpper and param. This is the param, the same param that will receive the text input. But here is a slight interesting thing. I wrote handler as makeUpper, but here my name is prefixed with onGet. This has to be done. If you write it like this, makeUpper, then this will not receive the request. So it is very important that the handler should be prefixed with onGet on the server side. This is the correct name. If the handler had been, let us say, fx, then here the name should have been onGetFx. So this is how it has to be done. This is one important thing. This is second important thing. Otherwise, your things will not work. Then after that, we have put a small artificial delay, and we will be returning some strings. So we construct an empty string. If parameter is actually received, we convert it into uppercase and then use the JSON result to send the result as a JSON. Now, if you remember, this string will then be read into data, and this string will be used to display the message on the client side. So JSON result is the method on the server side that is used to automatically convert the result into a JSON format. We do not have to worry about how it does, but it will be converted into the JSON format. Then it will be available in this data. This is a simple string, so it is available as simple string. If it had been a complex object here, then we would have used dot notation to access the further properties. So that we can now run the project and we can verify that it works as expected. You can obtain the source code from me and then you can run it, or you can type it as I have explained. So this is how we close. Thank you.